Begin to speak. What ignorance is cannot be argued over anymore. It is too late for pleading. White picket dreams put you off the scent. The world is screaming, rooted in a trivial concern, in insecurities, in the need to make face and keep up and drown out the many voices within. Imagine a culture that has at its root a more soulful connection to land and to lovers. But I can hear the lie before you speak. There is nothing but progress to eat, and we are so fat and so hungry, and the black wrists are cuffed in the pig van, while the white shirt and tie in the tube car distraction and pizza. Pictures of beer and guilt about urges, sexual distrust and abandon to nothingness. Give me something I can nail myself to. Give me a savagely dressed talking head who has something about them I trust and despise, and what of it anyway? These windows don't open. They were designed to stay closed. Shower, smoothie, coffee, commute, check the internet, never stop, never stop. There is a scar on the soul of the world, and it needs you to look. The blood of the past is here, it remains. The blood of the murders, the bodies like sacks leaking grain, or stacked chest and back on the plains, it remains. To acknowledge without guilt, to accept without condition, and to listen when other people tell you how you have behaved. Truth is, it's for us to feel and be moved, but I hear the clatter of bone against steel. It is coming, it will not be stilled, it is there. In the air, scorched white, the reflection of sunlight on glass, bouncing back into sunlight on glass, bouncing back. Industrialized, denial. Business as usual. So roll your eyes, shake your head, turn away and call me names. I'm okay with that. Too proud. Unable to listen, we keep speaking. Motored by blood. Unable to notice ourselves. Unable to stop. And unwilling to learn.